Hello everyone, how are you doing? Back with a second video in a row. That does not mean I'm gonna upload every day. I was gonna upload every 2 days, but I figured out I'm just gonna upload whenever I have a day off. And whenever I'm done, or when I'm not busy. Because most of the time, when I do have my day off, I'm just trying to catch up on like video games and anime, and you guys know how that stacks up. And also YouTube videos as well, so I'm like, I have a lot of catch up to do, and by the time I catch up, it's like, I just want to just chill. But I'm going to shoot for a video every day off I have, so yeah. I actually made a recording earlier, but the quality of the games weren't that great, so I'm back with a second recording, actually. Oops, that was actually one of them. I was just checking what was his hand, and when I checked, I was like, I shouldn't post this. But anyway, I've been having fun with Lavals. In just one day, I decided to have a little bit more fun. I took a concept from NTD Zero because I just thought NTD Zero is really fun. Why don't I try splashing? Why don't I try in here? So I decided to put in an inch. Actually, this should be one duality and three molten. I guess I played with two duality last time in the previous recording. But anyway, yeah, three molten conduction fields is what we need. But yeah, I was just looking at NTDs. I was like, oh, let's see if I can actually put it into Lavals. Because honestly, when the engine itself is having problems, usually you try splashing other engines. I mean, I like splashing engines together. And I thought, hey, what's better than ninjas, right? So we're going to go ahead and jump into a duel. And let's see, there we go, that should be pretty centered. Anyway, any Laval players, oh actually that reminds me, in the last video I posted up, in the first duel, someone told me that I actually had OTK for on my first turn, and when I checked the footage, it's like, he's right, I didn't see that. So pardon me, I haven't gotten that great in playing Lavals or Flamville Lavals or Ninja Flamville Lavals or Ninja Flamville Laval Synchro. I don't know. I'm not paying attention. I almost MST'd my own card. But not terrible, because we have Flamville Fire Dog. It just means that we're able to set up the graveyard now. If we can. But if by any chance I feel like I'm playing against artifacts, I pretty much lose, because I don't have too much experience playing against that deck. And for some reason, I feel like I am playing against that. Set 5 back row. Do it. Do it. Oh my gosh, he's doing it, guys. Oh man, I'm playing against artifacts. Maybe I'm not. No, that's just Absorbing Jaw right there. Watch. Alright. We have to start hitting the back row. So we play that, and we send you and you, my beautiful ladies. That was weird. No. We'll send that. And your chain wall back row is pissing me off. What is it? Torrential. I get to play Yu-Gi-Oh! I get to play Yu-Gi-Oh! Yo! Yes, we get to play Yu-Gi-Oh! I don't remember I set to the graveyard. Oh, I just did that. Okay. See, you guys, I'm terrible at this deck. I don't even remember what I sent. What's that back row? Fiendish Chain. Fiendish Chain can't stop me! Okay, I guess it can. I can't go for game. I know that for sure. For sure. Because even I go 5, like even if I go into Dual Slasher, and then, actually I could go for game. Could I? If I like summon another level 4? Actually, let's not chance it. Let's play a little bit more safe. But you, seasoned Laval players, probably would have been like, you had game, bro. You just missed your chance. And I'm feeling ya. Gen X. Okay. Grunica, this is why you are awesome. Everything is awesome. Yes, I did see the Lego movie. I brought my nephew out to see it. Everything is cool when you're part of a team. No one wants to hear me sing, and I'm sorry, I'm having a ton of fun. And I'm being honest, I am having a ton of fun right now. Like I've been saying, I've never had this much fun playing Yu-Gi-Oh! In a long time. Man, Grunica is awesome. And we'll send you to the graveyard. And I think I win. I don't know what Gen X Ally or Gen X or Ally of Justice, Gen X Ally Justice decks do. I win, friend. Or okay, okay. So that was, I opened up too good, I guess, or you opened up really bad. I don't know. Let's go ahead and check the recording. So I'll see you guys back in a bit when I open it up. Alright guys, so let's see what he was playing. I guess he knew what he was doing because it's not full Gen X Ally. And he drew into Max C. I was about to go off on him. So he could have Max C'd me. And looking from his deck, he definitely knows what he's doing. So I just happened to draw too good, I guess. Because actually, if I drew too good, why didn't he, Because, okay, let's just move on to a turn and let's see real quick. See, if he had Max C and he knew I was playing Lavals, or Lavals, why didn't he, Like, if he waited and I used Rekindling, I would have been scared to actually play anything. Because, see, he would have drawn to that and I'd let him draw like 5 cards. Well, I guess it didn't matter, so yeah. Okay. So let's go ahead and jump in the game. I actually wanted to just show that, just so we know, you know, whether it's because I open up great or if it's the person I'm playing against isn't as experienced, or I just misplay a ton. I'd like to know. I think it's fair, you know, for you guys to know whether, you know, if I was playing against a bad player or a bad deck or just playing against someone that's just better than me, know what's going on. So let's go ahead and try again to another game, please. But I feel pretty bad. I need to let him get to play Yu-Gi-Oh! I mean, that's what Yu-Gi-Oh's come down to. Don't let the other person play Yu-Gi-Oh! But, you know, it's more fun when both players are trying to resolve their OTK, and when someone finally does their OTK, it's just like, oh, you're salty, but you're like, well, I got outplayed. Just like in the previous recording, I played against a scrap player. I was denying him as much resources as I can until I got into like a dead hand, and from one card, he was able to basically lock down the game. Alright, can you choose a deck, please? Thank you. He must have a lot of decks. Oh yeah. Dude. Yes. Oh man. Look guys, I just innovated Lavals right here. No, I'm just kidding. If I did, holy crud, I did. No. I'm just kidding. I'm getting that is basically me sounding like getting full of myself, which is never a good thing. You don't ever want to gloat. I mean, when it's something you're proud of, you know, you can gloat a little bit, but not to like, oh, I am the greatest, or I know everything and you don't, so you have to listen to me. Like, so gross. So we'll set and we'll figure out. Okay, I open up great. If he beats me, I know he's a good player. That actually sounds very snobbish. If he beats me, I know I didn't play as well. Dude, I win! I super win! Oh, what? Holy crud! Do I really just I just like own? What is that face down? Chain it. Just chain it right now. Lance. Okay. Oh man, I don't even know what to do. I mean, like I got plays for days, man. Okay, I don't really have plays for days. But okay, let's see. Let's see. Like I can go over every single play with you guys I have right now. Not really out, because by the time I explain it out, I will time out. So I can make a level 5 then level 7. If I have, you see, I have that. That is what can open up an OTK just because it can beef itself up, and I've done two of that. So what we can do is we make into a level 5, which would be hyper librarian, and then make that. That would require summoning this and getting out two tuners. So a 1 and a 3. Actually, it'd be better to pop a back row, but I can't do that because I need to have Hanzo just in case. So instead of babbling, let's do this because I am ready to play Yu-Gi-Oh! Like, I'm sorry you can't play Yu-Gi-Oh, but I am gonna have like a Yu-Gi-Oh day with you right now. Again, all of these sound so wrong coming out of my mouth. I apologize. Ooh, even that sounded wrong coming out of my mouth. What am I, 16, 13? No, I'm not. You guys aren't supposed to know that. Okay. Burn my dread, man. Draw and banish that. And then we will do this. Mash that to pop that. Ghost tricks. Okay, so now all I know is that if should I chance bouncing it? Should I chance it? I'm gonna chance it. You Laval players are calling me bad right now. I agree, I'm terrible, but I can't resist. It's just after one special summon, I just want to keep special summoning. It's like it's an addiction, guys. I've never special summoned so much before in Yu-Gi-Oh! Ah! We'll bounce that to hand. Okay. Okay. We have to check this one as well. Check two. I opened up great in like both games. So let's go ahead and check this out. Because it's only fair to know if I won because I open up great or if the opponent opened up crap. I know this game. I open up amazing. Okay, so I play, da da da, go into that, set up like a ton, right? And then he goes. So he has to set that. And once I bounce that was game. Yeah, I feel sorry. Not sorry, but I feel bad. No, I won. I shouldn't feel bad, but it's like he didn't get to play Yu-Gi-Oh! I set up my graveyard, I had two rekindlings, even if he did had something, I had ninjutsu art. It was not going anywhere. I was gonna win this, okay. Man, I sound cocky, I apologize, but man, like I said, it's just an addiction just trying to just once you play that one rekindling, it's like, oh, I need more. But okay. So, if you guys have any advice for me, the Laval players experienced, have some experience, plays with, against, or plays the deck Lavals, can you give me some kind of tips on like how to get yourself out of bad hands? I mean, I drew great. The past two games, I drew terrible. I'll tell you that. I actually will go ahead and jump into that. Just because, like, it was so bad my opening hands. Like I had, like I had Handmaiden in hand, and then like a bunch of super transformations and a Grunica. And then that was like my opening hand for most of the time. I had very little plays. So let's just do. No, okay. It was like. No, that's still decent. Oh, excuse me. That's still decent. Still decent. Let's look for a bad hand. Okay, no, because, you know, if it wasn't a Hanzo, hands like this, you can't. Like, just pretend that wasn't, or I couldn't even get into a Hanzo. Hands like that just, like, make me cry. There, this is a perfect hand. Hands like these, this is the type of hands I opened up with in the previous recording. I was like, nah, I don't want to show this. I mean, even though it's great to show the bad side of your deck, like, if you just open up so bad you can't really play, or you're just like, you know, even though it seems like you're in control of the game, you're just like desperately holding on. I don't want to post up videos like that because it's just, oh, I didn't even consider this, but whatever. But yeah, so I'll be working on that deck. So yeah, like I said, just let me know. Also, another thing. How are you guys liking these live duels and Lavals? I mean, you know, I know that a suggestion said, you know, have fun playing the game, and I DC, but whatever, we don't need it. But someone said, have fun posting videos. Two people, actually all of you, posted, you know, have fun posting videos. And I am now. I'm having a lot of fun. I mean, like, there's always a special place in my heart playing Zero decks, but, you know, sometimes it's nice to branch out to other decks, which is like, you know, what you guys want to see. So, you know, how are you guys liking Lavals? Do you think it's a boring deck to watch me play, or is there any like a type of deck you want to see me play? Because to be honest, I like combo piece decks. I like mixing archetypes. So this is something I really enjoyed because it was very reminiscent of Title Zero. In a way, with a Lakeside Lady. So, yeah. Anyway, this outro has been too long. I'll catch you guys in the next video.